students, today we will see our next practical in 353, extension 353, that is organization of group discussion. So this is a very interesting practical and very important practical, and with this practical you will get acquainted with the knowledge how to create a group discussion between the farmers, how to lead a group discussion in the every groups, and how to different group discussions can be handled for our successful anyone training program or within anyone seminar or conference. So different techniques are there. So the discussion is very important, but how to handle the group, how to create the topics and how to lead the topics, that's very important. So let's see. A group discussion, what it is exactly? So here we will see, the group discussion means a group of people organized for the purpose of, that is, sharing the information for the specific topics and analyzing and evaluating some information and get some conclusions. For that only we are organizing group discussions. So it's very simple that you are chit chatting with your friends, but at some time with that chit chatting you are not drawn any conclusions. But at the very important, every discussion should draw the some important relative information which is helpful for the farmers or which is helpful for the students. So whenever you are working with the which groups, farmer groups or parents groups or students groups, and what topic you have chosen, every topic should have some conclusion, and then your group discussion will be fulfilled very well. So what the objectives are there? So see, here some objectives are there. First one is the to help in the better understanding of the problem. So some situations arouse at the some peoples, and at that time they have some conversation with the their elder one, and that elder one people are giving the some techniques to them how to solve the problems, and that is also one type of discussion. So that discussion may happen with the family members or some expert members, and they will given the suggestions to farmers, to students, to elders, and that all. So just drawing the a conclusion and pulling the knowledge to solve the problems using that experience by giving the technology or by giving the anyone knowledge on some solutions. Second one, to generate the new ideas and methods and select the rational one through a group interaction. So it's very important that whenever we are discussing on any topic, at that time what we are doing, we are creating some new ideas to solve our problems, and that helps you whenever you are coming with your ideas in a group, and that more than 100 ideas you will draw with your friends and when you are drawing with your groups. So this is very new group interaction you can develop, new idea will be developed. Next, to act as a safety wall for reducing the tension. We sometimes see whenever your friends are very dull about any one situation, at that time you just message them that whatever the problem is there, just discuss with me, and that is the sharing of the problem. And if it is a possible to help him, you immediately talk to him that yes, I will help you, so don't be worry about it. So this is a safety wall is there. Likewise, you are doing a help to your friend, and with the small conversation, with the small discussion, you will solve it. So here we have to learn how a farmer can be get help from our discussion. So the discussion should be healthy, the discussion should be wise about the solution. Next, to plan a program for action means we have to, whatever the planning is there about the organization of program, that also we can plan well with the group discussions. So many ideas will drawn, so many people will discuss about the problems and solve their own also. So with the group discussion, every problem can solve, every problem has a solution, that is a better understanding of the group discussion. Next is the the different types of or techniques of the group discussion. So this is a particular question regularly asked in your final exams, that is the define group discussion and explain well that group discussion techniques. So these are the techniques also and different types also. So first one is the a small group discussion. In this group discussion, 5 to 6 members are there. So what the 5 to 6 members will do, that there is a one leader in that group, they will assign that person as a leader and they discuss the topic which is a prominent for their problem. Next one, the leader role is there to conclude and to be in touch with the same topic till until the any conclusion. Because sometime what happens, we start the any one topic discussion, but at that time we lost the tempo of that topic, we lost the continuity of the topic and we are going around the subject. So here the role of the leader, that he has to be come again with the topic and he should be stick up to the topic. So this is the small group discussion. Next one is the panel discussion. Here the 3 to 4 experts persons are there and they are taking the initiative as an one person. We can claim him as an chairman and other members are the members. So in that 3 to 4 members in one of the play as a chairman role, and his role is there that introduce the topic, introduce the and guide them about the discussion and just be in touch with that what we should be the next problem is there and what we have to conclusion or what we have to discuss. So the chairman role is very important in the panel discussion because no one should go around the subject, we should be go deep of the subject. Next, the audience hear the discussion among the experts and the experts generally have the rehearsal of that whatever the problem they will discuss among the peoples. So the expected questions they are drawing, that what general situation is there and what the farmers will ask the question about them. So they rehearse that and they prepare their own for the questioning which can be asked by the farmers. And this type of discussion is very good for the presenting a controversial subject. In this way, the other experts are discussing about the benefits, loss and whatever the bad rocks are also there. So they are discussed there and with the panel discussions, whatever the panel members are there, they are discussing and the audience listen them and take a conclusion. Yes, which one is the technology will beneficial to us. Next, the symposium. So what is the symposium? The symposium is a discussion method in which different viewpoints on a single aspect of the subject. So a single point on the subject we have to discuss in the symposium. For example, disease of bajra. So that is a single topic, diseases. Which one? The crop is one only. So that symposium will give the more and more research and they publish the document about the how to identify the diseases, how to control the diseases, what the control measures are there, what the treatment should give. So these are can be taken by the symposium. So the symposium is a series of the speeches and on a single topic. So there are 5 to 6 members will be there, that speakers are there. So they should not to be exceed their topics more than the 20 minutes. And there is also a chairman person who introduce the topic and discuss and inform to the audience that what the different speakers given their views on the that particular topic. Are you getting? So next one is the workshop. So what is the workshop? You people may gain that is the workshop may be somewhere places where we have to form our own machineries, we have to do the workshop works, that iron works and all that things. Maybe that also you can say, but again with that same workshop in you are building some information in workshop where you can build up your own material and likewise you are creating a conclusion, you will utilize some library facilities and you will develop the improvement in your whatever the service knowledge you are having. So you can say it as an a training also, okay. So with that workshop, some one day or two days workshops are arranged for the upgrading the knowledge, and with that workshop the skills acquired, and that same skills will be utilized in the your service also, and some farmers will attend your workshops for the how to control measures for the mango trees, how to taking care of the pheromone traps after the use. So these are the small workshop you can organize for your farmers. So as the whenever you are attending for the Ravi, at that time you need to organize some workshop also. So how to attend, how to prune to anyone plants, how to give the knowledge to for the different topics, then seed treatments are there, some cutting and prunings are there. So that also a small training program you can organize under this workshop. So it may be goes for the one day or again a week for also you can organize for the workshop. Next, this is also like a working conference, means in the conference you are giving information, but in this workshop you have to say just perform that activities. Next, the conference. So newly you have to attend that what is the workshop, then you have to going for the conference. So what is the conference? A conference is a gathering of people for period for the intensive discussions. Intensive discussion means a major problems will be discussed at that. So 2-3 days maybe we can organize the conferences. In these conferences it can be held for the presenting information what the research they have done. Next, exchanges of the experiences, what the experiences they got in that research, that is also they are sharing. Next, training to the improve old skills and new one skills, that is also useful for the conference. And the problematic discussions whatever are there, we have to solve them. Next, the forum. So what is the forum is there? Forum is a discussion period that may follow any one of the method of the presentation. So any one of the method of presentation means you can organize the conference, you can organize the small group discussions. So in that small group discussion, if you see here the one thing they are setting in this small group and the large group, the more than 5 people they have gathered here, it means the a large group discussion is there. So with the large group discussion, it is a consistent of the a question period in which the members of the audience can ask the question, and that person, this is writing a question on the board and he is trying to solve that. So it also provides the opportunity for the audience to clear up the obscure points. Obscure means which are tenuous points which cannot be solved by anyone thinks, that one person is not sufficient to think over it. So many ideas should be there. So with the forum you can collectively solve the problem with the different ideas come out from the farmers. So this is the additional information will be gained by this forum. Next one is there. That is the procedure. So what is the procedure to organize any one group discussion? See, it's very important. We feel that the group discussion is very easy. We can organize the panel discussion. We can easily organize the workshop. But there are some procedures to handle this group discussion. Though it is a very simply look easy, but it's not easy to draw the every results after the discussion. So what we need to do? First of all, participants, if more, then you have to divide them in a small subgroups. Second one, each group should assign some subject, a specific subject for the discussions. As we have discussed that some people may be available for you as in a panel, so you can organize the panel discussion. Some people may not available, but the group members are there, large number of people are there. So you can divide in a some groups, some 5 to 6 members you can gather them and give a single topic to them. So on that topic they will start to discuss among them. and one of the people should write the points on the paper. With this is a very useful thing to write the points on the paper. It will support to the writing report. Next, a specific time limit should be given to every group. So, what will help? It will help to conclude your group members as in a discussion points. Next, in the plenary session, each subgroup present their report to the group leaders, and the group leader's responsibility is there to provide this group discussion report to the their organizers. So, it will help to draw the group results very well. And we should not to contact to every members, we can contact to the leaders and draw the results. Next, that the questions asked by the any one person, that the clarification also can be sought by the expert members and expert comments. So, this is the a particular procedure to organize our group discussion. So, you should be ready for it for the your next procedures and next group discussion organization. So, here the what is the role of the chairman? As we have seen, panel discussion has the chairman. Next, in the every conference workshop, you have your leaders, you have your chairmen. So, what the role should be there? The role is there, introduce the members if they are new to any one other one. Second one, announces the topic and purpose of the discussion. Because what happens sometime, the people select the topics, but after 10 minutes, they reveal that group. So, if the topic is very important, so they should be stick up to the topic and discuss well on the topic. So, you have to give the why this we are discussing, the reason you have to tell them. Second, next one, the give the short summaries of the discussion from time to time whenever the required. Means you have to conclude their result and discussions after that what they have discussed really. So, what will happen? Really they are on a right track or not, they can judge well. Try to get balance the participation by controlling the talk between the persons and encourage the silent persons is very important of the chairman. So, the chairman should take note of it, every participant should participate in that group discussion and remain the personally neutral, because the chairman should not to be give his own opinion biasly about the any one person. So, here the unbiased nature should be very important by the every chairman in the group discussion, and do not dominate the discussion, encourage the lazy persons as casual participants to talk. It's a prime important information about the chairman, that he has to boost up to the lazy persons, he has to give the backup to the participants who are talking about the subject. You just give the enthusiasm, you create enthusiasm in your group to actively they will participate and discuss on the topic. Next, the role of the members. As the chairman is very responsible for the every discussion, but the members' role is very again important, because they are the person who will discuss the topic. So, talk one time at one only, because we have seen whenever we are talking in a group, every person is just chit chatting on the same topic on the same time. So, what will happen? No one listen to you. That is the very important, that our point should be listened to everyone. So, talk one person at a one time. Next, no private conversation with neighbors should be there. You should discuss among the group. Whatever the points are there, you should discuss among the group only, not with the single one person. Listen actively, it's very prime. No speech making, means just continuous talking is not important. Others participation, others speech is also important. So, just reveal your point, whatever you are want to deliver, and then just listen to others, what their views. Next, be the open mind. It's very important. If you are very conservative, you will just share your thoughts, and whatever the others are sharing, you are not listening. So, you are not a good member of for their members. So, you should also listen them what they are telling. supply as much patient information as possible. Means we should not to give the just angriest result or angriest opinion to every time. We should patiently listen to everyone and then we can reveal the review about our discussion. Stay connected with our subject, because some members are just doing the discussion and just revealing that discussion half. So with the half discussions, no result will drawn. So here we have to learn very well, and every member should develop the leadership quality, because sometime your members may be not interested to have any discussion on the particular topic, so you have to create among them. So this leadership quality may you given a chance to play a role of in the next time as a chairman. Okay, so here we will see the advantages. People will get an equal opportunity to take part in the discussion. Next, it creates the high degree of the interest. So who are very inactive person, they also will participate, they also will think over the problem and they will share the thoughts. So it will also help. Next, the develop morals of the group, because sometimes what happened, some people are just talking about the topics, but sometimes they are sharing their thoughts with the someone other people. So it's not a group morals. If you are in a one group, so you should discuss your topic with your own soul members only. Participant need not to try to a good speaker. They just have to be give their thoughts. They should not to give the speeches. They have to be share their thoughts very openly and do not be shy. Next, improve the individual's capacity for the participation and critical thinking. So we have to insist to the farmers, we have to insist to the people to participate in it and share their thoughts, and appeal to them to do the all sharing whatever they thought about the subject. And it's a cooperative effort, so you and your members, you and your peoples should cooperatively work and should cooperatively solve the problem, and that is the role of the group discussion. So everything is having some limitations. So as in our agriculture field, for the group discussions we also have some limitations. If you seen, some villagers are not participating due to the other peoples. Next, sometimes some politics are there, some with other groups, so due to that also they are not participating in your group discussion. Sometimes some peoples are may not having a self discipline, and due to that also your group discussion results may not drawn correctly, because some people keep mum, so they are not talking anything, so the healthy group discussion may not happen well. Next, sometimes some people are very new to the topic, and so due to that they cannot enter in the topic whenever the group discussions is going on. And some peoples are having some very extraneous work, likewise their seasonal works, and due to that your farmers may not attend your group discussion, though they have so much curiosity about your subject and your group discussion, so they may not attend your programs. So this is very important, that if farmers are not having the time, so we have to arrange the group discussion as per their availability and their choice of the subject. So on their problems, on their choices, they will discuss well, because they like these things, and due to the just going through that situations, they can discuss and they can draw some conclusions. So here we have closed our topic, we have finished our topic, that is the practical on group discussion. So this is the practical and theory information I have given you. So you have to be worked on the group discussion with your family members also, and you can collect their reviews on what they have just thinking about the any one topic or any one situation. So this is your practical you have to do at your home, and you have to write a report on it, what your members have given a review to you, and that will be the farming situation you have to collect, or the current situation, that is the a corona situation is there and what is impacting on our farming situations or farming activities. That also the topic you can discuss, and you have to write a report on it and submit me on the Google Classroom. Okay, thank you.